So we will wait for 1 minute, then we will start our session. Today we will discuss the new part in the module 2, which will be the J transformation, right? This is the new module. So already we will discuss the introductory part in a very few days ago. Okay, so I think you will forget all those things, because the J transformation and the Laplace and the Fourier transformation is the important part of a control system engineering. So you need to understand the J transformation. And accordingly, we will perform some numerical analysis on the J transformation in the control domain, and we will also discuss the Laplace transformation and the Fourier transformation, and how the J transformation that will involve in the discrete time signal, as well as a as well as the what will be the J transformation formula. So that thing we will discuss today, if the time permit, right? So today we have to go through the introductory part of a J transformation, because already we will discuss the introductory part of a J transformation is a long back. Okay, so I think you will forget all those things. So again, we will recapitulate all those introductory part of a J transformation, so that you will able to understand what the J transformation is. Because before understanding the J transformation, so the application area of the J transformation is very much huge in the control system domain. So we will start the introductory part of the J transformation. Okay, so I will share my screen so that you will able to see. Wait for a second, I will share my screen so that you will able to understand. Okay, so I think my screen is visible. Yeah. So yes. So this is my module 2. So module 1, that will consist the introductory part of a control terminology, that means the various control structures. That thing we will discuss in the module 2. We have to discuss the J transformation. So depending upon the various formula that will associated with the J transformation, and what will be the control logic using the J transformation, that thing we will discuss in this particular module. Okay, so module 2, that is purely based on the J transformation and its application area. Okay, so first we have to discuss the module 2, which will be known as my JIT transformation. Right. Okay. So, what will be the, what do you know about the JIT transformation? Right. So, JIT transformation. So, first question that will arise, that is, what do you know about? Know about the JIT transformation? And the second question that we'll ask sometime, okay, that means what will be an application area? What will be the application area of JIT transformation? Right, so these are the two things that we'll discuss in this today's lecture. Right, so what do you know about the JIT transformation? That means the introduction. Right, so in the introduction part, so because we are using the various mathematical tools, okay, that which will be commonly used for the analyzing or synthesis, or we can analyzing the discrete time control system. Okay, so in case of a discrete time control system, we need to implement the JIT transformation. So, okay, so JIT transformation that will be applied in a various mathematical tool that will be involved in the domain of control engineering, right? So the mathematical tools, so the what will be the JIT transformation? JIT transformation is a mathematical tool. It's a mathematical tool that will commonly use commonly used for the analysis and synthesis commonly analysis and synthesis of discrete time discrete time control system, right, is a JIT transformation, right? So this JIT transformation is involved in a discrete time control system. Okay, so to determine any such kind of a system response, okay, the in such a cases we can say that what we can say, suppose if you are considering a linear discrete time control system, because the discrete time control system will be divided into the two different segments. One is a linear discrete time and a non-linear. So first we have to discuss the linear time disturbances. Okay, so the role of the JIT transformation in the discrete time system is similar to the just like as a Laplace transformation in a continuous time signal, right? So there will be the two difference between the two different control system. One is a discrete time control system, another one is a continuous time control system. So in case of the continuous time control system, that will be deals with the Laplace transformation, and if we will consider the discrete time control system, that will discuss through a JIT transformation. So keep in mind these things always. If we will considering a continuous time signal, if we will considering the continuous time signal, that will be deals with the Laplace transformation. Right? Okay. And if we will discuss with the discrete time system, discrete time control system, or the control signal, we can say, okay, so that will be deals with the JIT transformation. Okay, right, so this is very important part. right? Okay. So in a linear discrete time control system, a linear differential equation that will characterize the dynamic system, the dynamics of a particular system, because we are considering the linear discrete time control system. So as we will considering a linear differential equation, so linear differential equation supposed to be a differential equation supposed to be dx dy plus 2 into d square x dy square plus supposed to be k is equal to 0. So that should be considered as a linear differential equation. So linear discrete time control system is supposed to be assigned for a linear differential equation which will be characterized as a dynamic of any particular system, right? So to determine any such kind of dynamic system response to the given input, okay, such a differential equation can be solved. Okay, so any such kind of linear differential equation that can be solved using this linear discrete time control system having a J transformation, right? So with the J transformation method, the solution to the linear differential equation become the algebraic in nature. Obviously, keep in mind these things. So what are the different aspects of the J transformation? First of one is actually to determine the system response, to determine the system response for the given input, whatever the input we are given, for the given input, such type of differential equation can be solved using J transformation. Right? So with the J transformation methods, we can say with the help of the J transform. Okay. So with the help of the J transformation, the solution to the linear differential equation, equation become algebraic in nature, actually, right? So just like because if we are using the Laplace transformation, the same thing we are applied in the J transformation. Just like as a Laplace transformation in a linear time invariant differential equation into the algebraic equation. So in case of a Laplace transformation, the linear differential equation that will deals with the equation in S domain, right? But in case of a J transformation, the linear time invariant differential equation into the algebraic equation is J. Okay, so keep in mind this is always. So if we will considering the Laplace transformation or in case of a Laplace domain, so whatever my transformation or the time invariant differential equation that will deal with the equation of a S, okay, equation in S domain, right, in case of a Laplace transformation. But in case of a J transformation, the linear differential equation that will be solved, in a J domain, right? That thing you keep remind, okay. So we can say the main objective of this particular section is that if we will presenting some definition of the J transformation, so the basic theorem that will be associated with the J transformation is the method to finding the inverse test transform, because this particular chapter we will discuss with the Z transformation and the inverse Z transformation, right? So Z transformation is the one part, and we will be also deals with the inverse Z transformation, right? So inverse Z transformation, so later on we will discuss the inverse Z transformation. First we will discuss what will be the application area of the Z transformation. So here we have some objectives related to the Z transformation also, and as well as the inverse Z transformation also. So for solving the differential equations, any such kind of differential equation, suppose we are having a differential equation, so we are solving this differential equation by the Z transformation method, that is also been discussed in this particular part. So if in the examination, if you have one differential equation, so in the examiner, suppose one differential equation is there, and the examiner will told you solve this equation using the Z transformational methods, right? So how could we solve these things, say this differential equation, by a Z transformation method? That thing we will discuss in this particular segment, in this particular module, right? So later on we will discuss, suppose we have given a certain differential equation, and how we will solve this differential equation using a inverse Z transformational method. So that thing we will also be discuss in the latter part of this particular module, right? So now we will discuss actually what the discrete time signals is. Okay, so as I will already discuss in the previous module, that the continuous time signal supposed to be like this. If we have a continuous time signal, so continuous time signal, it look like this. So this will be the continuous in nature, right? So continuous time signal like this, okay? And the discrete time signals, it should be like this. So the discrete period of the time, so if in the axis we are putting the time interval t, so supposed to be, if we will considering 0 t 2t 3t like this, so depending upon the different values of the discrete time, okay, discrete time, we will considering our signal like this. So this will be my continuous time signal, this will be my continuous time signal, and this will be taken as consideration as a discrete time for the discrete values of a time interval. Okay, so discrete time interval, right? So discrete time interval. So what do you know about the discrete time signal? Now we will told you. So here we will discuss. One second, I have a call. Hello. 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 ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে ঠিক 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 ঠিক। হ্যাঁ বলো জিপানি কখন? আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, মানে না 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 ঘরে নেই, আমি ক্লাস নিচ্ছি, ক্লাসে নিয়ে যাব, ঠিক আছে। হুম হুম আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, আমি নিচে যাচ্ছি, গিয়ে বলছি, ঠিক আছে। হ্যাঁ হ্যালো, হ্যাঁ বলো। হ্যাঁ 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 বলুন। হ্যাঁ এখন ঠিক আছে, আমি গেছিলাম একটু আগে, ঠিক আছে। হ্যাঁ আমি অফিস ইয়েতে আছি, কলেজে আছি ওই। হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে, কালকে একটুখানি ইয়ে হয়েছে তো ওই কারণে ইয়ে হয়েছে, ঠিক আছে, অসুবিধা নেই, ঠিক আছে। হ্যাঁ 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 সেই 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 হ্যাঁ 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 না হ্যাঁ না রাত্রিবেলা একটুখানি কান্নাকাটি করছিল, ঠিক আছে, রাত্রিবেলা ভালোই কান্নাকাটি করেছে, ঠিক আছে, শোয়ার আগে তো সেই কারণে। ঠিক, হ্যাঁ 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 সেই সেই হ্যাঁ 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 সেই সেই হ্যাঁ সেই সেই আচ্ছা ঠিক ঠিক আছে, হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ সেই আচ্ছা হ্যাঁ সে আমি বুঝে দেবো। আমি এই একটু বাদে যাব, আমি একটা ক্লাস নিচ্ছি, নিয়ে আমি যাব, ওই ভ্যাকসিনেশনটা আজকে হবে তো আমি একটু ওই 12:30টার সময়, আমাকে ওই যে দেবু স্যার বললো যে তুমি চলে যাও 12:30টার সময়, ওখানে নাম লিখিয়ে দিয়েছে, তো এই একটু বাদেই বেরোবো 12:30টার সময়, ঠিক আছে। ঠিক, আমি গিয়ে দুপুরবেলা ফোন করছি, ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে। সো আই থিঙ্ক, সরি, ওকে, সো দ্য ডিসক্রিট টাইম সিগন্যালস, সো দ্য ডিসক্রিট টাইম সিগন্যাল ইজ অ্যারাইজ ইফ ইফ এনি সিস্টেম দ্যাট উইল ইনভলভ দ্য স্যাম্পলিং অপারেশন, ওকে, অফ এ কন্টিনিউয়াস টাইম সিগন্যাল। সো ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ এ ইনপুট হ্যাভিং এ কন্টিনিউয়াস টাইম সিগন্যালস, রাইট, so the discrete time signal that will arise if any system that will involves for the sampling operation of a continuous time signal. So we can say that the discrete time signal that will arise if the system involves the sampling operation of continuous time signal, right? So sampled signal like to be, so if we will considering one sample signal, so sample signal sampling signal likely to be supposed to be x of 0, right? So x of t, okay, x of 2t like this, okay, up to x of nt, right, where t is actually nothing but my sampling period, right? T is nothing but my sampling period, right? So such a sequence of a value, okay, this particular sequence supposed to be x to the power x 0, x t, x of 2t, x of kt, x of nt, like this. So this particular sequence of value that will arising from the sampling operation is usually written as a, so this particular sequence, okay, so sequence is x 0, x of t, x of 2t, like this. So this particular sequence we can written as a x of kt, right? So if the system that will involves in a if any particular system that will involves in an iterative process that will be carried out by the digital computer, because we are having a digital computer in the control logic. So if any such kind of system that will involve a iterational process that will carried out by the digital computer, the signals that will involve in a number sequence, okay, because the digital computer is only known the number, okay, 0 and 1. So if the digital computer that will involve in this particular process, so the signal that will involve is a number sequence. So number sequence will be, should be like this. So number sequence, so supposed to be x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, like this. Okay, this particular sequence, this particular sequence is a sequence of number is actually written as a x of k, right? So where the argument k that will indicates this particular k is, it actually indicates the order in which the number will be occurred, in order in which the number occur, then in which the number occurred in the sequence, right? Number occurred in the sequence. For example we can say supposed to be x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, right? Okay, so although we can say that the x of k is actually my number sequence, so it can be considered as a sampled signal of x of t. It can be considered as a sampled signal of x of t when the sampling period t, so when the sampling period, when the sampling period is t is in 1 second, right? Okay, so this particular number sequence that will be taken into consideration as a sample signal of a x of t, where the sample period t are in a 1 second, right? So we can say that the J transformation that will apply it, so this particular J transformation we can apply it on this particular continuous time signal x of t. So the sampled signal, this will be called the sample signal. The sample signal x of kt and the number sequence x of k. So in dealing with this particular J transformation, if the no confusion that will occur in this particular section, that we occasionally we will use x of kt, okay, and x of k, right? Occasionally we will use for interchanging all those components, okay? So that is to the simplify the presentation. So we occasionally drop the accelerated appearance of a t, that we will write like a x of kt as a x of k, right? So that thing you will understand in the introductory part of a J transformational methods, right? So I think I have to stop the session for today, because I have to go for some emergency work. So I have to stop my session for today. We will discuss this thing, we will continue these things in tomorrow. I have taken 1 hour classes, so that you will able to understand what the discrete time signals is. So I have to stop the session for today. So if you have any question, tell me. Okay, so if you have any question, so kindly raise your hands and tell me if you have any question on this introductory part of the J transformation. So if you okay, so then we should stop our session for today. I will stop my sharing. So thank you very much. We will again meet in tomorrow in the same timing. We will discuss the elaboration view of a outline of this particular J transformation, right? Okay. So I will stop my session. Thank you.